So I'm sure you're gonna meet the cleanest North Koreans on January 1st in North Korea. And because this is truly the only holiday for the people. If you feed somebody else, your children are gonna die from starvation that day. Therefore, nowadays actually North Korea, when you go to someone's new home, and if it's a meal time, they don't say, "Oh, have you eaten?" They actually say, "You must have eaten." Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Jamie Park and I'm a North Korean defector human rights activist. So, Happy New Year guys. This new year really made me to think how drastically different my life was when I was in North Korea and the things that I had to do to survive. So today in this video, we are going to talk about top 6 things that North Koreans must do to survive on New Year's. You know, it's been amazing being in America, that where we have this freedom of movement. People take airplanes and go places, meet their loved ones, having these lavish meals together. However, in the same time, in the same earth, North Koreans do something so different that you cannot even imagine. Because for them, this even on New Year's, what they do is depending on their survival, whether they're gonna get executed by the regime or actually continue to live. So number one, the first thing that you do on New Year's Day is when you wake up, you clean up the portraits of their leaders. So the dictators, the Kim dictators. Every North Korean building, including the house, including the train, library, I mean school, classroom, anywhere that you go to North Korea, must have the portraits of the Kim dictators on the most clean wall. And on this day, you have to wake up and you have to use this red cloth that is most precious, so expensive. You clean the portraits with all effort you have. By mistake, if you break the glass on the portraits or rip it, you are going to get executed. How you deal with this portrait is the most important thing for North Korean people. Once you do that, you have to put it back on the wall, and then as a whole family, you sit down and pay respect to the dictators and how grateful they are. On this day, at any moment, the officers, the secret agents can just break in and check if you have a little bit of dust on the portraits of Kim dictators. If they do catch, they catch with a white cloth and check, and if there's one little bit of dust on the portrait, they say your royalty is not good enough, and they get arrested that day, and they will send you to political prison camp along with 3 generations of your family. And after you clean these portraits, as a group in North Korea, if you're school children or a father and mother, everybody belongs to a group in North Korea, it's a collectivism. Then we all go together to the monuments of dictators, and we have to pay our respect with the fake flowers. In North Korea, there's not many greenhouses and there's not really good heating system, so it's very extremely hard to have a plant during the winter time. And because of that, this fake paper or plastic made flowers are so popular, we have to buy them in the black market and go to these monuments and pay respect. I'm sure those are the phrases you constantly see from out of North Korea, where people first go and pay their respect. Second thing that you have to do on New Year's is memorizing parties planned for the New Year. So this is something I'm sure you haven't expected this. It's a holiday. North Koreans work so hard, and this is a time they wanna rest, but not on New Year's again. So this is a very rare occasion that North Koreans actually get electricity. But the reason is unbelievable. The reason giving people electricity that day, because they want people to know about the parties planned for the New Year. So on this day, we get electricity, we even get the newspapers. And normally newspapers are so precious, the commoners don't get it, but we get it. And on TV, they read the newspapers for the people. The reason is because we have to memorize the entire front of the newspaper, and sometimes in backwards for the high officers, they have to memorize more. For even sometimes 5 pages of little words on newspaper, word by word, you have to memorize it. And then you have to go to work and go to school, you they are gonna check if you memorize word by word, and if you did not memorize word by word, again, you are going to be punished and go to concentration camp. So North Korea, instead of us thinking of our loved ones and celebrating New Year, people terrified of getting caught and sitting down, getting the newspaper rolled out and memorizing it like religiously as a crazy people, because that's what the regime requires people to do. We are not human beings, we are slaves to the regime. And I still remember my neighborhood, that who I called auntie, and she was a high ranking officer in the military. And on the New Year's, she was like, did not want it to be New Year because it was so much work for her to memorizing more portion than average people like us. And that is a day also why we get electricity, because we have to watch TV that day to be brainwashed again. Third one is actually, I'm sure you have not expected this. On New Year's, actually the right before New Year's Eve, we all take bath. And here's the reason. In North Korea, we are still living in the mid-dark ages. We don't have electricity other than New Year's, and we don't have, you know, running water, we don't have a running heater system. Therefore, people take bath few times a year. In the summer, we go to the river and we just like wash up in the river. And then in the winter, that is the only time we usually take a bath. So on December 31st, usually people bring the water from the river or the well or any stream and heat it up. And this like firewood are so precious. But on this day, North Koreans do it because we somehow believe that if we wash on New Year's Eve, that all the burden, all that difficulty of life gonna go away and bring us a good luck. So North Koreans take bath on December 31st, and on New Year's, we all feel very clean. So I'm sure you're gonna meet the cleanest North Koreans on January 1st in North Korea. So number four, North Korea has a very generous culture where we like to share things and respecting elders and taking care of each other. However, the difficulty of life, having going through this mass starvation for, I mean, years, almost 80 years now, made people really become, you know, different. Because in a way, if you feed somebody else, your children are gonna die from starvation that day. Therefore, nowadays, actually, North Korea, when you go to someone's new home, and if it's a meal time, they don't say, "Oh, have you eaten?" They actually say, "You must have eaten." And then you cannot say, "You have not eaten." And that's like, it's almost ethical. You cannot go to North Korean homes and say, "I have not eaten. Do you have some food?" That is the rudest thing you can do in North Korea. But January 1st is different. People actually try their best to be generous, and they do everything they could to have some food. So if the guest comes, and they feed the guest. So on January 1st, North Koreans do their best to go out to the neighbor house to fill their stomach. And of course, at home, we have to do the same thing when the people come and feed the people. And on this day, people really, one day, for just one day, they don't worry about too much of food and then get fed that day. So this is not all bad, even though we have to be terrified in the morning. However, there's still some kind of that love that people share, you know, and taking care of each other. Number five, it's also something that we have to do, and is as a culture that respect elders, we have to pay the respect to the ancestors this day, and we have to pour the soju, which is a rice alcohol, and then, you know, rice cake to ancestors and remember them. And this is a big thing for North Korean people, because we really grateful for the ancestors, the people who brought us here. Even though life for North Koreans are miserable, unlike being in America, North Koreans have so much respect for their ancestors, what they went through to preserve life, to preserve next generation. The last one is actually funny. As a child, I did a lot of this. As a children, you have to go around and bow to and wish good luck and good health for the elders. And if you do that, they're gonna give you cash, money. And you can buy gum or a little bit of candy that day. And the children have to go do that. And then as an adult, it's a lot of pressure because you have to have money to give to them. But still this day, where people, you know, go around, exchange and share love. And at the same time, of course, in this day, because electricity comes, and this is a time also the secret agent are the most working hard. The secret agent in North Korea don't get paid that much. Their salaries also less than $1 entire month. There is no way they can survive. The only way they can survive as officers is they catching criminals and getting bribes. Therefore, they go around the houses and looking for people watching foreign movies. And this is the only time the North Korean people get electricity, a lot of them do, and they get caught, and they get disappeared, and they get sent to prison, and they have to bribe, and a lot of times they get executed. However, a lot is happening for New Year for North Korean people because this is the only occasion that we can eat and we can have electricity. People treat this holiday as if the most important day of the year, and because this is truly the only holiday for the people. Other holidays like Kim Il-sung's birthday, the other holidays Kim Jong-il's birthday, and Kim Jong-un's birthday, Kim Jong-un's mother's birthday, Kim Jong-il's mother's birthday, and all the Kim's family birthdays are the national holiday. And on these days, North Koreans don't rest. We have to go to stadium, we have to be mobilized, this collective, you know, a horse show to show our respect for the leaders. And January 1st, still somehow a little bit reserved for the people, and they can really enjoy being a human. I hope really this video gave you some perspective how grateful we are living this country where we never have to worry about if we can feed our children or not. Sometimes it really wake up me at night and just thinking about children in North Korea. As a mother myself, I cannot imagine being a mom in that country and not knowing if you're gonna feed your children, they're gonna die from starvation or not. So thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit that like button so more people really know about what's truly happening in that darkness, in that communist evil regime, and more people really understand the value of freedom and fight for freedom. Love you guys, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.